call to order. Would you please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
May we have a roll call, please?
Mr. Pavoni?
Here.
Ms. Perez?
Here.
Mr. McIrvin?
Here.
Ms. Switchy?
Here.
Mr. Person?
Here.
Mr. Prince?
Here.
Mr. Corman?
Here.
Roll call, Mr. Mayor, all present.
Thank you, Jason. First item on the agenda is a special presentation from our museum. Liz Stewart.
Thank you, Council President Pavoni and members of the council. Thanks for the opportunity to speak to you tonight. My name is Elizabeth Stewart. I am the museum manager for the Renton History Museum. And I just want to take a few minutes tonight to introduce you to our newest exhibit that we're very excited about. It's called Sorting Out Race, Examining Racial Identity and Stereotypes in Thrift Store Donations. It is a traveling exhibit that was put together by the Kaufman Museum at Bethel College in Kansas. And we're very excited to be able to host this. It's a timely exhibit. For some years, the museum has worked toward becoming more representative of our very diverse community. And we've partnered with Renton High School and the English as a Second Language program at Renton Technical College to explore the experiences of our very racially and ethnically diverse population in Renton. This exhibit, Sorting Out Race, presented the museum for the first time the opportunity to take the history of racial stereotypes head on in a way that we hope will contribute to positive community dialogue. I know there's so many initiatives going on in the city that are addressing issues of race and inclusion, and we're excited to be part of that conversation. So the exhibit uses thrift store donations that depict racial stereotypes surrounding many different groups. And it leads the visitor to kind of question their own old ways of thinking. The exhibit demonstrates how historically stereotypes have contributed to the oppression of many Americans and how stereotypes have diminished all of us. Sorting Out Race is full of objects. We've gotten lots of compliments on the many objects in the exhibit. And the objects themselves, I think, bring home just how wrong-headed past ideas about African Americans or Latinos or Native Americans or many other groups have been. Thanks to a community advisory committee that included Councilmember Ruth Perez, Communications Director Preeti Sridhar, and City of Renton Diversity and Inclusion Consultant Benita Horn, the museum has developed a full calendar of events and programs that we hope will support the exhibits. We're offering a range of opportunities for dialogue and learning, as well as fun, that we hope will be positive for Renton. We've already hosted a spoken word and musical performance by the students of Cry Out. And this Saturday at 11 a.m., we have a performance by Native American storyteller Roger Fernandez coming up. The exhibit is open Tuesdays through Saturdays, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. until May 17th, and the public can find out more on the city's website, rentonwa.gov, or on the museum's Facebook page. And I thank you for a quick opportunity to talk about this exhibit. If you have any questions, I'd be delighted to answer them or in the future.
Thank you, Liz. Any questions from council?
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, Mr. Person.
Just a comment. I want to compliment Liz. She has that museum humming and has just done a fantastic job since she's been here. And we know she's put in a lot of hard work, and we really appreciate it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Renton is a wonderful place to work.
Thank you, Liz. Okay, moving on to administrative report, Mr. Covington.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, Council, a couple of items for yours and the public's awareness. Wanted to just let folks know if they're interested in working for the city of Renton or actually looking into other jobs in the community, they can check out our website at rentonwa.gov and type in jobs and you'll be led to a website. They can also type in governmentjobs.com and it will take you to a different website that will show sites that are available. We'll link those up so they can just get to our website and they'll be able to get to the other website as well. Lots of opportunities, both full-time and summer help as well if people are interested. We want to announce the Spring Shred-a-thon. It'll take place April 29th from 9 to noon next door at Sam's Club. People can, again, get on our website for more information about that. The new edition of What's Happening and Golden Opportunities, those guides are available now for folks who are interested in looking at summer programs, both for seniors and for others in the community. And just want to also emphasize that we're having, that from Saturday, April 22nd through May 6th, from 1 to 5, the Department of Ecology and the Don't Drip and Drive program are offering free auto leak detection workshops for the public at Renton Technical College. So folks can go there and get some good information and help in keeping the environment just a little bit cleaner by hopefully reducing the leaks in their cars. And as we all know, spring is, we think, coming. Today certainly doesn't look like that, but it's around the corner. Calendar assures us. Just a reminder for folks using our parks of our rules and regulations, dogs are not allowed at Coulon Park or at Kennedale Beach Park. All other parks do allow dogs on 6-foot leashes. The city does have an off-leash dog park that's located along our Cedar River Trail, 1500 Hauser Way, that's just across from our community center. Pet owners, please obey the scoop your poop law. Reduced speed limits and dismount zones are posted along the Cedar River Trail for bike riders. That is an active trail that's used by pedestrians as well as bike riders. And we do hope our bike riders can enjoy the trail while being especially courteous to walkers. I think, one other item that just will be some intermittent closures. We have a number of work road projects going along. One I want to mention is just intermittent closures on Lake Washington Boulevard just north of Hauser Way. And Gene Coulon Park, that's, we're doing some grinding and paving, and that is always a busy street, and so that may cause some traffic slowdowns. But in all the other areas, you just want folks to use caution and help our construction workers be safe. That's all, Mr. Mayor.
Thank you, Mr. Covington. And at this time, I want to call Preeti up to introduce one of our members from the Inclusive Task Force.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. Council members, I'm Preeti Sridhar. From the mayor's office. The city has been developing relationships with many of our ethnic, diverse, cultural groups in the city, and one of those special relationships is with the Latino community. This has been especially of key significance and importance in the recent past, with a lot of questions about the status of immigrants and what their expectations are. And, we did have a proclamation about those details a few weeks ago. Today, it is my pleasure to introduce Chaplain and Pastor Martin Fernando, who's one of the leaders from our Latino community group. He has something special to share with the city. I'm not going to take his thunder, but would invite Pastor Fernando to speak a few words and have something for mayor and council.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Well, I'm over here today as the first time, and it's a pleasure to me to be over here with you, to anybody. I'm going to represent the Latino community in Renton, and also I'm a pastor. I'm a chaplain also in Renton and different areas. And today I come to say thank you to the Dennis Mayor, and I got something for you through the community. This is all the business, locally Latinos business over here in Renton, and I want to say thank you for give the city of Renton and to anybody protection to the immigrants. So I'm Latino, and I'm gonna come today to give you this award for you.
We do a picture down here.
Vicki saw me walking out.
Well, thank you very much for being here this evening. We really appreciate it. Chaplain Fernando is very involved with their inclusion task force and a very active member and has been very helpful to our organization, so we appreciate all the work that he does. Okay, moving on to audience comments. We have one person signed up to address the council. When I call your name, please come to the podium, give your name and city of residence for the record, and you have 5 minutes. That's Christian Comeny.
Hi, my name is Christian Comeny, and I live in Kent, Washington. I wanted to ask the council today what you guys do for homeless people and how you might affect change.
Well, you know, you're asking a very complicated question that would take probably two or three evenings to answer. So, but we're not, and I'm not diminishing your question because I think it's very important. And we would be happy to spend time with you, not during the council meeting, but to explain to you all the different things that the city's doing to address homelessness and the concerns that we have in regards to homelessness. And so I guess the best thing I could suggest is if you could leave your contact information with one of our staff members here, and we could try to set up a time where you could come in and we can go over some of that with you. Right. Would that be okay?
Yeah, that would.
Okay, great.
Thank you.
Thank you. Of course, unless there was a council member that had the quick answer to.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes,
Mr. Berman. There is no quick answer. I would start with the Renton Housing Authority and how amazing it has been in producing so many subsidized units, over 1,000 subsidized units. But still, we obviously have a big and growing homeless population, and I agree, then the solutions start getting more complex. And yeah. Thank you, though, for the question.
Okay, moving on to the consent agenda, we have 8 items for council consideration. Are there any items a council member would like pulled for discussion?
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, Mr. Pavoni.
I move that the council concur with the consent agenda.
Second.
It's been moved by Mr. Pavoni, second by Mr. Prince, that council concur with the consent agenda. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? The ayes have it. Moving on to unfinished business, Mr. Pavoni.
No unfinished business, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, Ms. Perez.
No unfinished business, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, Mr. McIrvin.
No unfinished business, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, Ms. Witchy.
No unfinished business, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, Mr. Person.
You know you weren't going to get by me.
That's right, we knew that.
I have a couple of committee reports.
Okay, Finance Committee report, the 2017 carry forward first quarter budget amendment ordinance and amending the fee schedule. The Finance Committee recommends concurrence in the staff recommendation to approve an amendment to the 2017-2018 budget appropriations in the amount of $67,570,325 plus an additional $50,000 for the float replacement at the Cedar River Boathouse. This makes the total amended budget to be $543,328,619 for the biennium. The Finance Committee recommends concurrence in the staff recommendation to amend the 2017-2018 fee schedule to incorporate the changes in Section 8 airport charges. It is further recommended that the following changes be incorporated. Section 1 for miscellaneous fees regarding notary attestation to $10 each signature per year. And then Section 2, the Maplewood Golf Course, increase the weekday nine-hole fee to $27 each year, increase the weekday nine-hole senior fee to $19, and decrease the golf cart fees nine-hole to $17 for 2017 only. The committee further recommends that the ordinance regarding the carry forward and first quarter budget amendment be presented for first reading, and that the resolution regarding the amended fee schedule be presented for reading and adoption. This is signed by the committee chair and members.
Yes, Mr. Mayor.
Yes,
that is a big, big number that we're talking about, but there's some really big projects within this, including the Sunset Lane project that we're giving an additional $700,000 to. And my favorite topic is that we're using some narcotic seizure fund money to buy some police vehicles, a couple major police vehicles. And the idea of the carry forward budget in general is that these projects that have been contracted and started in the previous year, and the money hasn't been spent, but they're ongoing projects, so we're carrying those forward, the money forward from 2016. There's a few additions in there that the committee reviewed. None of them in themselves, other than the big, you know, Greg always has to have the big one, $700,000 contribution to the Sunset program. And the reasoning for that, I think it's very important to note, is they're putting in the roadway up there and all the infrastructure. And what they found, whereas the franchise utilities like PSE usually come in and put in that infrastructure, and then they ask the question, well, where are we going to connect these two? And they say, well, we haven't built them. They haven't been built yet. And they said that they won't pay for it ahead of time because there's no building there and the tariff schedule wouldn't allow them to do that. So in Greg's wisdom and his staff's wisdom, we are installing those utilities. So when we have a brand new road, people won't say, why are you just put that new road in, why are you digging it up? And then the plus of that is that as people hook up, there will be a latecomer fee, so we'll actually end up being reimbursed for that expenditure. But I am so happy, and the public should be so happy, that we have staff that thinks ahead and say, oh, if we don't put that in now, we'll be digging that road up, and then people will say, you just put it in, why are you digging it up? So with that, I move the council concurring the recommendation of the Finance Committee.
Second.
It's been moved by Mr. Person, second by Mr. Prince, that Council concur with the Finance Committee report. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it.
I haven't had a chance.
Okay, the final Finance Committee report is regarding vouchers. The Finance Committee approves for payment on April 17, 2017, claim vouchers 355174 through 355175, 355178 through 355180, 355189 through 355202, 355223 through 355574, 5345 through 5356, and 10007 through 10010, and three wire transfers and one payroll run with benefit withholding payments totaling $6,262,981.03, and payroll vouchers including 606 direct deposits and 42 payroll vouchers totaling $1,218,985.25. This is signed by the committee chair and members.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes, Mr. Person.
Jason continues to marvel me how you can run those numbers. Anyway, you know, I can't let it go without a couple things. But just for the public, our PSC bill, our electric bill for those traffic signals that we don't like or we like, was $295,272.58 this voucher run. And just to provide emergency services for the police through Valleycom was $418,277.69. And we had a couple camp cleanups where people call in and complain about encampments and the trash that cost us $4,116.07 to clear. And with that, I move that we adopt the Finance Committee report.
Second.
It's been moved by Mr. Person, second by Mr. Prince. The council concur with the Finance Committee report. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Thank you, Mr. Person. Next is Mr. Prince.
No unfinished business, Mr. Mayor.
And Mr. Corman?
Yeah, Mr. Mayor, this might be a good place to just make a comment that I didn't get to make during the committee of the whole meeting. We had a very good presentation, a great presentation that the our Public Works had gone out and looked at slide hazards in the city, and we kind of ran out of time. I wanted to thank Greg Zimmerman for his role in that. The consultant, I think, has left now, but very, very important. Really, it's heartening to see that you're keeping an eye on all of the steep slopes in town. I thought all of the analysis was important. Obviously, watching out for Maple Valley Highway is really critical. I did want to just add that I was really happy to see the emphasis on Honey Creek. And you touched on the trails and you mentioned the utilities, and there's a lot of sewers and water lines and things down there. The trail is a really valuable asset, and you did mention it, and I know you're watching out for it, and you're obviously out there repairing it. But for anybody that's not been on this trail, when you take that trail, which is basically, it was an old road, it's like a road that's over 100 years old. My understanding of the history of that road is, I think even before automobiles, it was like a road that was part of mining. But it's I always just know it as Devil's Elbow Road. You feel like you're in the whole rainforest when you walk down this road. And on any nice day, just like the day we just had on the weekend, you'll find lots of bicyclists, lots of pedestrians, many people from the neighborhood. And it's actually a really kind of vital connection for bike commuters from the Coal Creek side over to the Kennedale side, where it saves you miles out of your way on much busier streets to take this trail. And then if you actually walk down to the where it hooks, where the elbow is, there's a trail that parallels Honey Creek that's even more beautiful. And the city's been maintaining that with vigilance and watching as alluvial fans slide down and kind of correcting the flow. And I just want to say, I mean, the trail system itself is sort of a priceless asset. So I appreciate what you're doing there, as well as, of course, guarding those utilities. So thank you for that. I wanted it to not go unsaid after you talked about it tonight.
Thanks, Mr. Kerman. Okay, moving on to legislation, we have one resolution and one ordinance for first reading.
Okay, the resolutions regarding the amended fee schedule. Resolution of the City of Renton, Washington, adopting the amended 2017-2018 City of Renton fee schedule.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, Mr. Person.
Move the resolution be adopted as read.
Second.
It's been moved by Mr. Person, seconded by Mr. Prince, that this resolution be adopted as read. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it.
Okay, the ordinance is regarding the amended budget. An ordinance of the City of Renton, Washington, amending the City of Renton fiscal years 2017-2018 biennial budget as adopted by ordinance number 5824 in the amount of $67,570,325.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, Mr. Person.
I move the ordinance be placed on second and final reading at the next council meeting.
Second.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes.
I just make sure that the intent of the motion is to include the $50,000 in the Finance Committee report. So that's not part of the total. So it would be, $67,620,325. I think when we will do the amended.
That was the numbers. Intention.
Thank you.
Okay. Been moved by Mr. Person, seconded by Mr. Prince, that council place this ordinance on second and final reading at the next council meeting. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it. Moving on to new business, Mr. Pavone.
Yes, Mr. Mayor, on April 24th, 5 p.m. in the Conferencing Center, the Committee of the Whole will have three items on the agenda. The first is a briefing on the Family First Center. We'll also have downtown streetscape design standards and guidelines, and the downtown redevelopment, including the Civic Core upgrade. And also, Mr. Mayor, I'd like to say to the Transportation Department and Greg in particular, thank you very much for what we've done down there on the corner of Main and Second. I have to travel through that intersection pretty much every day, and I have been contacted by the businesses down there, a couple of them in particular, and they're very appreciative. The amount of work that we're getting done in that small zone and being able to still move traffic through there has been fantastic, so
I've been impressed with that, too.
Yeah. Kind of an elegant solution.
Well done.
Thank you very much. That is all, Mr. Mayor.
Okay, thank you. Ms. Perez?
No new business, Mr. Mayor. Thank you.
Mr. McIrvin?
No new business, Mr.
Mayor. Wow. Ms. Witchy?
No new business, Mr. Mayor.
You're kidding me. Should I skip Mr. Person?
Go ahead. But people want to get their paychecks.
Yeah, that's right.
Anyway, the Finance Committee will meet on next Monday, April 24th at 4 p.m. in the Council Conference Room. We have five topics: vouchers, FINI grant funding amendment, facilities division restructure, upgrade salary of signal/electronic system supervisor to grade A25, emerging issues in revenue streams. And Mr. Mayor, just on a happy note, let the rest of the council know and the public know that on Wednesday, Council President Pavone and the mayor and Chief Milosevic and I, we barbecued, had an appreciation barbecue for the dispatchers and call receivers at Valley Communications.
Very nice.
And I think they were very, very impressed.
They were very impressed.
In not my ability, but you guys' ability to flip.
No, they were happy with it. They loved the steaks and they loved the attention, and it was a nice event. And it is really amazing. I know all the council members have been able to experience what goes on at Valley Communications, but that call center is busy all the time and can be very stressful. If you can imagine the 911 calls coming in and being able to handle it in the professional way they do, they are a remarkable group of people that provide a tremendous service. And so I know they appreciated the barbecue very much.
And just one more little issue that Mr. Pavone reminded me about. As for Greg, the detour down on Mill and is working good, but I've had one complaint. Is when you come to the Mill and Bronson, there's a sign that says detour this way, And it's kind of confusing to people because they think, oh, I've got a turn. Oh. I can't continue on to Bronson Way. Right. So yeah, maybe we could have somebody.
Sorry, Greg. I thought he was going to end it on a happy note about we will look at that. You're right. That people would be confused and they would turn there. So we'll take care of that.
I figured it out, though.
Thanks.
I'm not the complainant.
Mr. Prince.
Yes, Mr. Mayor. On Thursday, April 20th, 2017, at 4 p.m., the Planning Development Committee will meet in the Council Conference Room. We have four items on the agenda: shopping carts, docket number 12, comprehensive plan amendment process briefing, and emerging issues in community and economic development.
Okay. That's all, Mr. Thank you. And Mr. Corman.
I just need to announce, Mr. Mayor, that the Public Safety Committee meeting, which would have ordinarily been held on April 24th, has been canceled.
Okay. Thank you. Mr. Pavone.
Yes, I move that the council meeting recess into executive session for approximately 20 minutes to discuss labor negotiations with no official action being taken, and the council meeting will be adjourned when the executive session is adjourned.
Second.
Okay, it's been moved by Mr. Pavone, seconded by Mr. Corman, that we adjourn into executive session for about 20 minutes over labor negotiations. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Ayes have it.
I think the reason forgot that.